Namaste, dear friends. Now, in current affairs, we are every day reading about the Me Too movement. For that sake, today, we want to know more knowledge about Me Too. Thought of Sindhura Ahoratra, who did her law, asking this question. But those who are interested can also know about Me Too movement. Sindhura did IMLI International Maritime Law Institute, Malta mein maritime law kiya hai. You all know about that. But today we talk legal about Me Too. Sindhu, namaste.
Namaste everyone.
Dear friends, talks should be in English so that everybody can understand. That is the intention. Avaru kannadigare ella ondu sala namaste helutta ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೂ ಈ ವಿಚಾರ ಮುಟ್ಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಏಕೈಕ ಲೈವ್ ಮಾಡುವ ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈವ್. ಸಿಂಧು, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀ ಟು? ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್.
Okay, so Me Too is basically a campaign which was started to address sexual harassment and abuse victims and tell them that they are not alone in this whole perpetration of this sexual harassment as a crime. And that it's okay to be a victim of it, but it's not okay to be silent about it. It's not okay to be ashamed about it. It basically tries to tell people that they can be open about it and speak about it and give solidarity to everyone who has been suffering with this issue. It tries to bring up this issue and increase the tell everyone the magnitude of how much sexual harassment and abuse is happening in our country and around the world actually.
Beta, what is word Me Too represents? Me Too, T-O-O. Why that name? Who invented this and who take it out and which country it escaped? What is the purpose?
Okay, Me Too is basically as simple as it sounds. It just means that me too, myself, I also have been a victim of sexual harassment or abuse. And sexual harassment is so rampant that every other person, every other woman mostly, has gone through this incident. So Me Too actually was used as early as in 2006 by an American social activist. She started using this to address victims of sexual harassment and abuse and tell them that basically, do not be ashamed of what you have suffered with. A lot of people in the world are going through this. And in 2017, it was first brought into the social media platform through Twitter. And from there, it has picked up. And we see now what it is.
Okay, maybe this Me Too movement came in the intention of positive intention. But for every positive intention, there is an equal and opposite negative problems will arise. By taking the advantage of Me Too, do you think so many people who are wrongly suffering?
That is actually true, because the actual purpose of Me Too is to build a community, is to actually break the culture of silence that revolves around the whole topic of sexual harassment. And what is sexual harassment? We need to understand that first. Obviously, the definition keeps differing jurisdiction to jurisdiction. But in India, sexual harassment has different, it can be of various types. It can be verbal, it can be non-verbal, it can be through words, it can be through gestures, it can be through sounds, it can be through physical contact. So when a person makes any physical advances to a woman, which is unwanted, she's not expecting it, she doesn't want it, she's not interested in it, and that would constitute sexual harassment. If a person sings lewd or obscene songs, makes lewd gestures, that would be sexual harassment. If a person shows pornographic images to a woman without her consent, that would amount to sexual harassment. If anyone makes a woman uncomfortable by doing anything that is unwelcome by her, that would amount to sexual harassment. So there are various forms of sexual harassment that Me Too is trying to address, especially in India. But what is happening is, though the Me Too movement is trying to say that it is not a small issue, huge issue, it is poorly conceived, because people are coming up on social media platforms and they have started naming people, which is actually, in the course of trying to get justice, is obstructing justice. We need to understand why it is trying to obstruct justice. Because when a person is named on a social media platform, what are they trying to do? They are trying to say that this person has committed this crime of sexual harassment and we need to bring them to justice. So if you're trying to bring them to justice at a platform like social media, here the media becomes a judge. The media here is a judge without following the rules of natural justice. Without following the rules of natural justice, why? Because the person who is accused is not even given a chance to be heard. There is no defined procedure of admitting proof. So what is actually happening is, even if the accused is a really accused person, the person is deprived of the opportunity to defend himself, which goes against the whole concept of fair trial. When you're going against the whole concept of fair trial, there is no real administration of justice. You're deviating from the administration of justice. So what you're trying to do is, you're shooting aimlessly when you're putting it out on social media, but by not trying to seek legal recourse. So if you really have been a victim, you need to take a legal action so that this is not reiterated. The person is actually stopped from doing so.
Okay, beta, but if the MeToo started, they didn't know that they should go through court?
No, MeToo, actually what MeToo was trying to do is, when actually a person has been a victim of sexual harassment, that victims have been for years together, for decades together, being victimized for being victims of sexual harassment. What MeToo was trying to do is to say that it's okay to be a victim of sexual harassment, but what it is not okay is to be ashamed of it and be silent about it. It has told people that please come out and speak about your problems, take actions.
But they should not take the particular person's name?
If you're taking the name, that means you know who that person is. You're so sure that this person has done it. So you should really take a legal recourse to it. That is, make a file a complaint. Say what actually has happened.
Okay, after complaining, after the court judgment, we can put it in social media?
Yes, you can put it. You can put it on social media. But what I'm trying to say is, if you're trying to resort to social media without even trying to take a legal action against an act such as sexual harassment, which is a very serious offense, what you're trying to do is, you're shooting aimlessly. You're not understanding what you're trying to achieve through social media. Are you trying to make the social media a judge of a person's character, of a person's crime, when social media does not really follow the rules of natural justice? If you really want to bring the criminal to justice, why are you not resorting to a medium which is already available, like this justice system? You can always file a complaint.
Okay, MeToo is a female supporting system or male supporting system?
MeToo actually female supporting system. It was actually greatly addressing female issues, because in the world, which is really true, a large amount of women suffer from sexual harassment and abuse. But though sexual harassment is a gender neutral concept, in fact, it is even age neutral, you know, like even children are suffering from sexual harassment. It's not just an adult who is suffering from sexual harassment.
Okay, that means even the men who are suffering from females in this harassment sections, they can also do MeToo, right?
Yes, but the point here is, what is happening is, the Indian Penal Code, for example, it under section 294 says, when a person makes any obscene comments or sings songs which are lewd publicly, then any person can take action against that person. But when it comes particularly to sexual harassment, and at that situation, it becomes a very woman-centric issue. It becomes a female-dominated issue.
But if you go to the court, if a boss is harassing an employee, or if a film actor is harassing a heroine, or if a director is harassing a heroine, but she don't have any proof, but she was suffered. But how your court asks proof? Where she will bring proof? But she suffered. But how, in that case, that female has to suffer?
Okay, so this is a very important topic. In 2013, an act was introduced, which was to help women and protect them against sexual harassment at workplace. So what this act did is, it built internal complaints committees, it built local complaint committees where women who suffered sexual harassment could go and make complaints. Because what happens is, when you're suffering sexual harassment in a work environment, there's a prejudice to your employment, there's a prejudice to your promotions, there's a prejudice to your salary. So women kept silent for a long time and they kept suffering. So what this tried to do is, it tried to break that culture of silence by creating a system wherein women could approach committee, and this committee would investigate into the matter and take actions and file reports appropriately. And if the committee thought that there was really a prima facie case, which is a real case which was formed under, which was fulfilling all the ingredients of a crime under the Indian Penal Code, then a complaint would be filed at the local police station.
If in the Me Too, if a ex complains about Y, that she has undergone a suffering with him, and if he moves to the court by telling a defamation case, is there any possibility that that blamed female will go to the jail or something?
Okay, so when you really have to see, So what happens is when you're making an accusation against a person, obviously there's a requirement of a proof. When it comes to sexual harassment, there are various kinds of proof. Proof is admitted in different levels for all kinds of crimes, civil or criminal. There is direct proof, there is indirect proof. Indirect proof becomes circumstantial, which is like they try to derive a conclusion from different circumstances. Now what is happening is when you're making a public statement about a person being accused on social media, you're basically creating an environment where the person's reputation is tarnished even before the proof is admitted. So media judges even before proof has been attached to the statement that is made. So an allegation is no longer an allegation, it is a conviction. Unlike in the justice system, there is an allegation and then there is a conviction. So there is a clear differentiation. Justice system follows the concept of presumption of innocence until proven guilty. But what is happening on media is there is guilt before the innocence is even like shown, you know. So the person is declared guilty just by a statement that is made, which is completely against the rules of natural justice. And in a court, for example, if you're actually proceeding in a court, a case is filed in a court, and the media tries to bring about the facts of what is happening on a media platform, the media starts judging the person based on what is happening even before the court declares its verdict. So what is happening
here? Do you mean that a media judge of the media, like that social media judge, is not completely right?
It is. It's not about being completely right or wrong. What a social media is a judge which is not following the rules of actual justice. It's deviating from the rules of natural justice. So here what it is happening is, for example, the court is trying to give its verdict, but here the media has already given its judgment. So when it's already given its judgment, it's prejudicing the justice system. It is hindering the justice system from administering justice. So what it is really doing is contempt of court. And contempt of court is a serious crime. A media trial is contempt of court. A media being a judge, even before a legal system is administering justice, is contempt of court. And contempt of court is a crime. So when you're in the process of trying to seek justice, you're going against justice. So it's for everyone to really think about, is this what I want to do when I'm actually pinpointing names in public? When I'm pinpointing names in public, think about it. What do you want to do? You want to bring justice. You want to bring the perpetrator to justice. Is this how you want to bring
justice? Do you think all this blaming people or not knowing this law?
I think what is happening is the whole process in the blame game is being diluted. It's becoming more of a name shaming.
Okay.
Over trying to seek justice.
Or a male undergone this sexual harassment or child abuse, yes, after 10 years that child can go to the court. For example, a child suffered in the childhood,
yes,
with somebody, yes, school teacher or any person, mama or uncle or anybody, and disturbed her, but she keeps that in the mind. After 10 years she can move to the court.
Okay, so this is very interesting. So we have a very special act for prevention of child sexual abuse. This act is very important because it's addressing a very strong issue of our society, which is a big menace. Child sexual abuse leads a very strong problem in the minds of kids who are growing up, who are the future of our country. So when it comes to sexual harassment issues, even for child sexual abuse, when a crime is committed and when a complaint is filed, there is obviously a limitation period. For example, if today the crime is committed, depending on the intensity of the punishment that crime would call for,
okay,
then, but what happens in some cases is that the victim is young. There are certain situations where the victim is unable to file the complaint. There's so much disgrace, there's so many other things which are involved. At that time, under the Criminal Procedure Code, they try to extend this, they try to make an exception to this process by going beyond the limitation period. So the limitation period in exceptional circumstances does not really apply.
Okay.
As per the exceptional circumstance.
But India is made of villages. Our back spine is villages. In the villages, there is lack of education. And parents are uneducated, child is uneducated, and the leaders of the any person or any big shot people are disturbed the child or troubled the child, and child doesn't know where to move and whom to complain. And at that case, even though if they complain and go to the court, but in the she has to live with the same environment, who protects the child? Who protects the family?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So for that, you have a lot of you have like non-governmental organizations. There are a lot of these groups which actually enable support to it. So there are a lot of great people working in this field trying to ease the pain that a lot of people are going through sexual harassment at various levels and various ages. But we need to actually develop a lot more in actually implementing what we have in place today.
Okay. Beta, what's your recommendation for the all these Me Too activists? A request, or being a female, you support these females or males, or what is your view about that? Can you explain that?
Okay, I think Me Too is actually a beautiful moment. It is a radical change in the society. Like I said, it has broken the whole culture of silence that we had towards sexual harassment.
Okay.
Like initially, we used to be ashamed that, oh my God, this person has been sexually harassed. But no, you should not be ashamed. And that is the biggest change that it has brought in this century for all of us. So that's a big deal. So what Me Too has done is bring solidarity. It has created a big support system for a lot of people. But when you're doing so, when you're trying to bring support to a lot of people, please do not interfere in the course of justice when you have a serious accusation against a person on social media. Please, 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 by wanting to take a legal recourse is the best option that you can do. Because what you're trying to do is, in your course of seeking justice, you're deviating from justice. And if you really want justice, please do not play against justice.
Snehitre, idu Bharata desha ella matte Bharatada aachigina janannu nodta iruvanta live hagagi naavu kannadadalli maatadlilla. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ, ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಇವನು ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಥ ಲೈವ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಇದನ್ನು ಬೇಕಾದರೆ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ ಇವನು, ಮೀ ಟು ಅನ್ನುವ ನಾನು ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ನಿನ್ನ ಜೊತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದು. ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಒಬ್ಬರೇ ಸಫರ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಜೊತೆ ನಾನು ಇದ್ದೀನ, ಇವಾಗ ನಿನ್ನ ಕಷ್ಟಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಧ್ವನಿ ಎತ್ತುವ ಒಂದು ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದು. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ನ ಹೆಸರಿಸಿ, ಪ್ರೂಫ್ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಹೆಸರಿಸಿ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಮೀ ಟು ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಇಲ್ಲವೋ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಕೋರ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಆ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ತಪ್ಪು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕುವುದು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದು ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾರಾದರೂ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ನಾನು ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಎದ್ದು ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಅಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಇದು. ಇದನ್ನು ತಿಳಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಲಿ ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು. ತುಂಬ ತುಂಬ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ ಗೆಳೆಯರೇ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೊ ಮಚ್.